Hi guys, today is another Trading 212 portfolio update. I know it has been a long time since I've done one. Hi guys, this is Mosh and I can't believe how the whole year has gone. I'm still in shock when I look at my accounts. If you're new to the channel, I started trading and investing just over a year ago. Before that, I was a complete novice. I knew nothing about trading and investing. I initially started off with £500 because that was a maximum I was willing to lose. Over time, I have just been building up the profits in my trading account, transferring to my investing account, and using the power of compounding. Compounding is one of the most powerful things I have learned.
I told you my compound would take you places.
Einstein said it is one of the wonders of the world. The reason I show you guys my portfolio updates is so it can inspire you. If I can do it, being a complete novice, so can you. And with me, I am self-taught. So everything that I learned was from books, from YouTube videos, and a few other sources. You can start your journey by getting a completely free share worth up to £100 with Trading 212 or Free Trade using my link below. All you have to do is open up an account, deposit £1, and you get a free share. Why have I done so well? At first, I thought I was just getting lucky. I started in April 2020. I initially started trading, and what I started doing was I was using those trading profits and moving them into my Trading 212 Invest and ISA accounts. It's very hard to get rich quick.
They see our ads in the back of Hustler and Popular Mechanics, and our ads actually say they can get rich quick.
This is a long-term game. I thought I was just getting lucky. However, every single month, I was making profits, and I was surprising myself. So I started learning more and more about the stock market, about investing, about trading, and just building up my knowledge. One key thing is building up my psychology around it as well, because I think that plays a big, big part as a trader and an investor as well. I also use both technical and fundamental analysis when it comes to my trading and my investing. And especially my long-term stocks, I do a lot of research around those stocks and I'm in there for the long-term, for the next 5-10 years. Unless something changes, then obviously I'll react with the market too. I also learn from my mistakes quickly.
It makes me learn from my mistakes.
I've also started another channel called Mosh Money Shorts. Go subscribe and check it out. It's just explanation of different things in the investing and trading world under 1 minute. Definitely worth checking that channel out. And I'll appreciate a like on this video. Now it's time for a portfolio update and a few things have changed since I done my last update. Go check those out if you weren't sure. Remember, I started off with £500 and this is one of my accounts. This is my Trading 212 ISA account. I also have two other invest accounts with Trading 212 and I've got my trading account and two crypto accounts. So this has been a very good year for me. Okay, if we jump into the portfolio, you can see my return currently, I'm up 18.67%. However, it says the invested amount is £21,000. I messed up last year on my ISA account. A lot of Chinese companies are not available on the ISA account. They're available on the invest account. For example, Nianexpeng, I bought and sold, and I transferred the profits over onto my ISA account. Now, one thing to be very careful of is if you transfer money out your ISA account and then try and put more money in, if you reach your tax-free allowance of £20,000, let's say I withdrew £2,000 out, then I tried to put £2,000 back in and I was up to my £20,000 tax-free limit. It's not gonna allow you to do that. So as you can see, I've only used up £7,400 of my ISA allowance this year. So I've still got quite a fair bit left over. And I'm gonna try and use that up before the 6th of April, 2022. My ISA account is for long-term holdings. So Ceres Power Holdings, I had that before. I've been planning to buy more and more shares of these because I really like the company. They basically develop hydrogen fuel cell. I think hydrogen is gonna be the next biggest energy source. So I'm very bullish on the whole hydrogen sector. All right, I'm still holding IAG SA. I was contemplating selling it around, if I jump onto the chart, I was contemplating selling this around 210p, but I'm gonna stick to my guns and stick to the technical analysis. For me, it's playing within this symmetrical triangle, and I think, especially in a couple of weeks, it will break up to the upside, and my target is gonna be around 300 pence. Because the airlines are bound to recover. It's just taking longer than usual. Okay, one is a 3D company. I actually plan to buy more of this. It's SPAC, and they've done a merger with a really good 3D technology company. I think 3D is definitely another underdeveloped market, And for the future, it's going to be one of the biggest and game-changing things around. Okay, Origin Materials. This was a SPAC that's recently just happened. I've changed my mind on this, doing a bit more research around the company. I might take a little bit of a loss. I'm going to see what happens in the next couple of weeks. All right, the next company, Palantir. Again, I'm very bullish on. And as you can see, the last few months, it was in a bit of a loss. The whole growth sector took a bit of a hit. And you can see I'm in profit. Again, I'm going to hold this long term because I think this has a big future. In life, we're overloaded with data. I think we personally have too much data now. So this is a company that works for governments, for big companies, and it builds software platform to basically organize that data and analyze that data. Okay, Plug Power. Looking back now, I went in too high. I went in around $51 and currently it's trading about $32. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to average in. So I'm going to buy more and more because this is one of the biggest hydrogen power companies. And I'm going to dollar cost average in. Powerhouse Energy, I'm still holding on to. I don't know at the time why I bought it, but I did. As I said, I've not got much in it, so I don't really care too much about that. And Senvion is wind power. Now, it did recently do a nice big climb up. A couple of days back, it got to around 23 pence. I might just do a risky one and put like £1,000 in and just wait for another big pump, because I have a feeling it's going to happen. That's all it is. It's just a feeling. There's no other analysis behind it. And for me, my accounts are all looking good, so I can afford to take that risk. Sunrun, I have on my invest account a larger amount. Now, as you can see, I went in at $67. At the time, I thought it was a good price, but you can see there's a big sell-off. I'm very, very positive it's going to get back to that amount. That's why I bought a load on my invest account. So I'm very bullish on this. Now, the reason why I'm very bullish on this, first of all, it's one of the biggest solar companies in the US. They have realized they're behind on the solar tech and all these blackouts and power outages happening in the US and the electrification of cars. The US consumer market are going towards solar. Another thing Sunrun has as an advantage is built up solar panels on houses. I think they've done it for free, but what they do, they get the profits. Those solar panels last for 20 years. They will get regular income from those solar panels for making electricity and putting it back into the grid for 20 years. So just think about that. So they have regular cash flow. Okay, this one, Vivopower International. Now, this is, if we go to company details, it's an international solar and critical power services company. And I have bought 1,554 shares. Currently, it's worth about $8,500. My plan is to exit around $9. If you look at this, you can see, if I go to the daily chart, give you a bit better information. You can see before, its highest point was around $23. And it had another peak around $19. And around March time, it had a peak around $11. And currently, it's range bound. And you can see it's making these lower highs. So I think a breakout is due very soon. The breakout could potentially get to around $10. But I'm happy to exit around $9 because that would give me nice, tidy profits. Another thing about Vivopower is they recently done a deal with Toyota Australia where they're going to convert the trucks and electrify the trucks. Again, I think that's an underdeveloped market. Electrifying older petrol and diesel cars, I think that will be a huge market to come because electric cars are super expensive. So if it's cheaper for you to convert your old car into an electric car, I think that has huge potential. I hope you enjoyed this video and I'll appreciate if you give it a like and subscribe to my YouTube channel.